Miguel and Mario. Sir, would you please stand up for the recognition? Alampakan tanong. PBA Party List Representative Congresswoman Margarita Biggs Nograles. She is the daughter of the late Speaker Nograles. Chairman of Mindanao Affairs, our Silingan, our brother in faith. If he traces, can trace back his roots to the Sampurna clan in Wato, Bulindong. Congressman Bambi Imano, the chairman of Mindanao Affairs, from the great province of Bataan, representing the 1st Legislative District, Congresswoman Geraldine Roman. She is the chairperson of the Committee on Women and Children, Weekend, and Gender Equality. And of course, the hardworking congressman of the party list, one rider, Congressman Rog Gutierrez. Thank you all very much. For the information of everyone, under po kami ng brief ngayon, CNEDA, but these hardworking legislators opted to join us here to help us find ways in order that we can expeditiously finish the rehabilitation of Marawi City. So, panalamatan, with the indulgence of my colleagues, I'd like to speak in my verbatim language. Panalamatan tanong sila na inabrigi man to, na pinili yung inyong mga congressman o congresswoman na mapagtino sila sa public hearing, only to find out and to listen to you, because they are very supportive of the rehabilitation. And this is also a direct order from our speaker, Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez Jr. So, I'd like to give, yes, opening statement from our guest here, Congressman, maybe 1 or 2 minutes. We start from his first point, Geraldine Roman.
Magandang hapon po sa atin lahat. Nais ko lang sanang malaman ninyo mula po sa Kongreso at sa ilalim po ng instructions po ng aming speaker, Ferdinand Martin Romualdez, ay nagtungo po kami dito. Ako po, pangalong beses ko po nagtungo rin po dito sa Marawi dahil na ako noong 2018, just 6 months after the end of the siege of Marawi. At that time, ako po ay chairperson ng Committee on Disaster Management, and natasan po kami nung dating speaker para makapaglaro yun ng supervise yung mga bagay-bagay para mapadali yung construction ng mga temporary shelters and also moving forward to the mga permanent shelters. As the chairperson of Committee on Women and Gender Equality, kanina nagdilibot kami, nararamdaman ko po yung, at I appreciate yung best efforts ng mga kababaihan to make their homes and communities more livable, more welcoming, and of course, this is something meritorious, dapat kahang-hanga, dahil alam ko yung mga challenges na nararanasan ninyo. Alam ko merong element ng pagkainip, alam ko merong element din ng frustration, dahil matagal na natin iniintay na makompensate na po yung mga victims ng Marawi siege as well as ma-rehabilitate na rin itong syudad na ito. So, isahin po ang aming suporta. Kami pong dumating at bisita po rito. Mabuhay kayong lahat.
Thank you, Congressman Geraldine. We'll be here from Congresswoman Biggs Nograles. A short message.
Mayang hapon ka natin, Tanan. Kanina po, sabi nga po ni Chair Geraldine, na iligot po kami ng post po ni Pongzia and ni Governor Agyong Jr. Na nakita namin ang sitwasyon. At iba ang makita ang isang lugar at ano na rin nangyayari kasi nababasa niyo po sa news. And we're very privileged na nandito kami and honored na we are part of Congress now na meron tayong magagawa, especially as a Deputy Majority Leader, as part of the rules. Pagkatapos po nito, pwede po natin pag-usapan kung ano pa ang mga next steps natin at lalong-lalo na na patapos na po yun sa 5 years. Kung pwede tayong magpasa ng legislation that would siguro extend pa para talagang matapos po natin ito, especially na ito ay isa sa mga priorities ng ating House Leader, Speaker Martin Romualdez and ng ating administration na ito. So, we're welcome to hear kung ano po ang maririnig din namin maliban sa nakita namin today. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you, colleagues. Chairman Bambi.
Thank you very much. Salamat aikum, dagang salamat. Una pa salamat po kami kay Governor Diong and to the provincial government. And of course, our men and women in uniform for keeping us safe as we visited Marawi. And to the colleagues in the House of Representatives. And to the Barm government. As I have said during the press con, nung nasasinabi ko sa press con, maswerte kayo, Donald del Sur, may anak kayo, may congressman, na sobrang sipag, sobrang tiyaga talaga, na madala yung kongreso rito para marinig maayos ang problema na inaharap ng Marawi. Hindi kami malayo, nasa Misamis Oriental, halos boundary tayo. Ang development ng Misamis Oriental or Region 10 development ng BARM and development of BARM is a development of Misamis Oriental. The faster that we are able to restore Marawi back on its feet again, the better for Region 10 and better for the entire islands of Mindanao. Nandito po kami para pakinig sa inyo. Di na po matagal, naka-break kami. Balik kami pagsona ni Presidente at signal na ng sunod na budget hearing. Makakaasa po kayo, tutulong kami kay Congressman Adyong, tutulong kami sa mga hinihingi na mga kailangan para pagbangon ng Marawi. Lalo na special mention si Mayor Alonto, ng problema sa JICA and problema sa DAR, we will try to do what we can so that we will be able to hold on to the fund to develop the Marawi Lanao Link even better. Maraming salamat, mayong hapon sa tanan.
Thank you, Chairman Bambi. Congressman Chino.
May hapon ka na itong tanan. And as a fellow Mindanaoan, since ako taga Davao Oriental, it is honestly my first time makarating dito sa Marawi, dito sa Lanao del Sur. But at the same time, it is a great honor and privilege na makita namin yung Ground Zero at iba't iba pang mga magaganda mga lugar dito sa Marawi. And in fact, I am envious that you have such a place because we see the potential, especially in terms of tourism, in terms of development, na kung itong Marawi would be developed and restored, first restored and then developed, aba, it will most likely be one of the jewels of the whole island of Mindanao. So with that assured, kami naman with Chairman Bambi Imano and myself being a Vice Chairman on Mindanao Affairs and as well as Vice Chairman of Tourism, na lahat ng mga movements ng inyong gobyerno, lahat ng mga priorities ni Congressman Zia Alonto will be also prioritized by us. No? And in a way, na isa din namin na mapakitang suporta sa kanya. Because sa totoo lang, although si Congressman Zia has been one of my first friends pagpasok namin sa Congress, I have seen him day and night working para sa Marawi. And swerte again, as what Congressman Bambi said, napakaswerte ng Marawi, ng Lanao del Sur to have somebody like Congressman Zia. So with that being said, as his colleagues and as his friend, we will support all and every endeavor that he will push for the betterment and restoration of Marawi. Dagan salamat, may hapon na naman ulit.
Dagan salamat, Kong Chino. Wala akong putang sa'yo, no? Of course, the last colleague that would like to ask to speak for his message, Congressman Rog Gutierrez.
Assalamualaikum and magandang hapon po sa ating lahat. Muli gusto namin magpasalamat kay Governor Bombin Jong and to our host, Congressman Zia Jong, for having us here po. Nandito po kami ngayon para kita po sa public hearing na ito. Gusto namin pasalamat rin sa uniformed personnel nandito ngayon that made our place our visit very safe and very orderly. And syempre sa inyo po, sa pagbibigay po ninyo ng oras dito ngayon para mapaintindihan po kami kung ano po ang nangyari dito sa Marawi. Ang masasabi ko lang po ay, ang isang city ay reflection po ng kanilang tao, yung mga citizens po na nandun. And saludo po kami sa inyo. Nakita po namin in a short span of time, bumabago muli ang Marawi, pero naintindihan po namin na marami pa pong problema na kailangan na ayusin at kaya nandito kami ngayon. Under the direction of the Leader of the House, si Speaker Martin Romualdez, Ang ating direction po ay ibaba yung national government. Hindi po pwede puro ang mga desisyon ay galing sa Manila lamang na hindi po naririnig yung tao kung anong kailangan po nila. Kaya po dinala po kami dito under the direction of the leadership and to us hosted by your local counterparts para po makinig po sa inyo. And rest assured po, nandito po kami to listen to you, to hear you out, and we will try our best po na to act on it in a proper and fashionable manner. Yun lamang po, maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much, Comproch. Now, before we request our agencies, partner agencies, to give us an update, I'd just like to acknowledge the participation, of course, of our host. First is Governor Mabintal Bongbin Alonto Adyong Jr. Thank you very much, sir, for providing us the space to hold public consultation. Maraming pong salamat. We are also joined us here si former Secretary, now City Administrator, Ambassador Makabangkit Nanto, to represent the good mayor. I also recognize the mga different barangays from the most affected area. Maraming salamat po sa inyong presence. We also have here Mr. Dennis Solomon, is the Chief Post Disaster Evaluation and Management Division and under the Rehabilitation and Recovery Management Service. Asek Emmanuel Anthony V. Ramos, State Solicitor Joseph Ryan Abalos, Assistant Secretary Felix Castro under the Office of the President for the Marawi Rehabilitation, General Manager of Marawi Water District, Rusty Adyong, Mickey Makapantog, representing the Department of Public Works and Highways, from the Laso Rico, our acting General Manager, sir. I'm sorry, pangalan po nila si Percival, Sir Engineer Percival, together with Sadiq Lao, the one of the board of member of the board of Laso Rico, present also here, General Barongilio, 103rd Brigade, and did I miss anyone? So our PNP Chief Nakulan was also here. I saw him earlier. So sino po yung hindi pa po ano? Pasensya na po yung hindi po namin na recognize ngayon. So we would start with the updates from these three major categories that we cited earlier: housing, electric, and water supply. Maybe we start with housing, NHA. Do we have an NHA representative here? Or this one? Ah, yes, sir. Can you give us an update? What are the challenges that you face, and how do we move forward? We visited the temporary sites and the permanent sites. What are the problems? Do we encounter problems in terms of budget, and how do we move forward?
With regards to the National Housing Authority, Your Honors, we have already completed 1,500 out of the expected 1,800, with the 300 still to be completed. However, this 300 is now for downloading, with the amount of 150 units to be downloaded to the city government for their implementation, and another 150 units to be downloaded to the provincial government for their implementation in order to complete the total 1,800 permanent shelter units. This is now under process, sir, and the funds are to be released to the provincial government and to the city government of Marawi.
In terms of budget, we visited the temporary shelter and the permanent shelter. Are we looking at probably finishing all the units, awarding all the units to eligible beneficiaries? And what about the water supply?
With regards to water supply, sir, we are waiting for the LUWA to complete its assigned tasking in order for water to be delivered to the permanent shelter sites and to the temporary shelter sites. All water distribution lines have been completed in the permanent shelter and the temporary shelter.
Asset Castro, can you confirm? And what about the lands that are owned privately by some individuals? How do we move forward? Yeah, how do we move forward? There are also sites that we visited which are private lands. No?
Yes,
so how do we move forward?
For the
would you confirm what the NHA said?
For the temporary shelters, definitely those are private lands. But these temporary shelters have been turned over to the city, Marawi City LGU, who now administers these houses. Admittedly, there are already landowners who are requesting for the transfer of the IDPs. But unfortunately, the IDPs will still have to construct their houses in the most affected area. So Marawi LGU is constantly coordinating with the homeowners and the landowners to allow the IDPs to continually still occupy the temporary shelters. For the permanent shelters, the figures are correct. There are still some units that needs to be completed, both in Daduman, in Kilala, and Patani. Pero pa siya hindi tapos doon. And there are still completed units that have not been occupied.
Yes, sir.
Diba? May mga units pang hindi na-occupy, and this is now the priority of NHA na yung natapos ng units ay ma-occupy na ng beneficiaries.
Identified nyo, before we be recognized po, Chairman Imano, identified nyo ba yung possible na mga beneficiaries?
Yes, sir. The local interagency committee created for that purpose already recommended the list of beneficiaries to be awarded to the office of the city mayor. So we are just waiting for the final approval and endorsement of the mayor or the city mayor in order for us to effect the awarding and eventual transfer of our permanent shelter beneficiaries.
Yung mga permanent shelter ba natin ay na-identify na wala na kayong idadagdag na site?
Mayroon kami idadagdag na site, sir. This is in order to accommodate also because there is a clamor from sharers and renters na hindi na po makabalik sa Maag. So we are going to develop one site in Patani and another site in an NHA-owned property in Barangay Mapandayan. We can generate initially 150 housing lot units. However, we have we are hoping that we can convince the
NHA, sorry to cut you there, but when we visited Kilala, hindi pa siya tapos. So now, after hindi pa siya tapos, mag-gadungan, maglalagay kayo ng new site again?
Gadungan at Kilala, sir, is already pre-allocated. There are already beneficiaries intended for that purpose. So just in case that, because the sharers and renters cannot be accommodated in the permanent shelter sites. Those are only for house owners affected by the barangays.
Yeah, but ang tanong ko po kanina is that when we visited Kilala in Daduman, there are portions in the site that have yet to be completed. I saw there was a gymnasium to be erected there, and yes, there was also a school.
Yes, sir.
So, in terms of budget, do we see any problem in terms of budget?
No, sir. We still have available budget.
All right. So, once we do that, once we finish that, are you telling the committee that we would proceed with the proposal to build another site again while the Kilala in Gadungan have not been completed, the construction?
No, we have to complete first the permanent shelter for house owners before we start to develop shelter for
do we have a budget for that?
We're still looking for the budget, sir.
And can you please guarantee to us that you will propose that in your NEP, National Expenditure Program?
Yes, sir.
For the next site that you will build for another temporary shelter, temporary permanent shelters?
Permanent shelters are for sharers and renters.
Okay, sige. So, but we are building a shelter facility, permanent, this is community.
Yes, sir.
Hindi lang bahay lang, kailangan may tubig at saka may ilaw.
Yes, complete, sir, with concrete roads, everything, sir.
Asay, could you confirm? Okay.
Yes, sir, that's a pipeline new houses for the sharers and renters.
We would like to see that under NEPA, kasi budget season, we would like to see your proposal under NEPA. How many permanent shelters are you trying to propose? additional.
For the sharers and renters, sir, 100 in Barangay Patani and 50 in Barangay Papandayan. A total of an initial 150 units.
So have you surveyed and do you have any problem or any challenges that you may face in the long run dun sa mga owners ng lupa?
We do not foresee anything, sir, kasi sa Barangay Patani, this has been endorsed by MENRE. And for the Barangay Papandayan, this is NHA-owned property.
Yes, Chairman Manong.
Yeah. Mr. Chair, very basic tanong lang, Mr. NHA, sir. Ilang kailangan nito na bahay talaga? Total. Kailangan, lahat na affected, ha? Huwag mo muna sama yung renters at saka share. Ilan?
For the permanent shelter, the NHA has been tasked to deliver 1,800, to construct and deliver 1,800 units.
Yung 1,800, enough sa lahat na apektado sa Marawi, hindi?
Enough, sir, for...
Mr. NHA, sir, andito lang ng mayor at saka kapitan, ha? Buti, I hope that you know your answer well, ha? Yung 1,800, enough para i-cover lahat ng affected sa Marawi?
Yes, as to date, sir, it's still fast.
Okay, ha? Hindi pa kasama yung render na 100 at saka yung 50 yung nabanggit mo?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ito na lang, at the same time, because as our chairman had said earlier, kulang tayo sa oras, eh. Ito hihingin ko sa iyo, ha? Number one, ilan yung finished, tapos? Second, ongoing. Third, for turnover. Fourth, turnover. Apat, turnover. At saka pang lima, ilan yung pondo at saka bahay na kailangan pa natin sa lahat ng apektado sa Marawi?
Okay, sir.
And when can I get that? Mr. Chairman.
NHA. I can give you a copy of the report now, sir.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Where can I get it?
When can you provide that? Do we have that then?
Yes, sir.
Is that document signed, Mr. Chairman, by the one the NHA is speaking, Mr. Chairman? The gentleman?
NHA, can you confirm if your principal signed that document? Or are you the one signed that?
Ako lang ang nag-sign,
okay,
sir.
He's the regional director. Okay.
Mr. Chairman, can I ask that he signed all the pages and submit it to the committee, so it will be a reference that I will be using during the next hearing in the House of Representatives, Mr. Chairman.
Please,
we will comply, sir.
Thank you, and let me...
As a commitment again, Mr. Chairman, I just want to make it clear, will be this afternoon.
Yes,
before
sir.
We go, before
yes,
we leave.
Yes, sir.
Before we leave.
Yes, sir.
That's your final answer, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you,
Mr. Chairman.
Follow-up question, NHA. May problema ba sa downloading doon sa mga ongoing projects dyan sa Kilala at sa Gaduman? Kasi hindi lang na-download eh.
For downloading, Assessor.
I want an answer, not for downloading. You download it now. You're supposed to download that before pa, di ba? Kasi
yes,
nakakantayin ka dyan yung mga projects eh.
Okay, sir.
Can we also ask your confirmation that you will download? You work that. Alam ko yung process ninyo eh. Sa national government, you also request that funding. It's not your fault. Diba? But can you assure this committee that you will ask the national government and maybe in the coming budget hearing, we will pump this issue might pop up. Tatanungin po namin kayo at saka NHA kung na-download na. Can you give us confirmation that you would start requesting for downloading of the funds?
We have already requested, sir, and I will make the necessary follow-up and I will also make the necessary report, sir, should okay. The funds not be downloaded immediately.
Okay, thank you very much. Asek, would you like, ano may sasabihin po kayo? Okay, mayroon pang follow-up questions po sa mga members. So, thank you. Any other requests from the members? Yeah, okay. So we will be submitted the documents that you requested will be submitted today. Now we move to electricity. Last Oreco, can you give us an update? Yes, Congressman Rodriguez.
Mr. Chair, just a point of information on po, no? Kasi, apologies po, no? We're still new to this. We're not aware of the full, ano? Yeah, good ask has been explained to us. There was already an original 2,500 permanent houses that were installed. And then now, on top of that, 1,800. would that be, just to follow up on the question of the good congressman from Samis Oriental, would that be sufficient for all internally displaced persons?
Do you have the data? Yes. Who can answer that?
Mr. Chair, I just want to inform that Social Housing Pinas Corporation contribute for the permanent shelter housing. Together with the UN Habitat, the fund was for the UN Habitat will build the houses. Social Housing Pinas Corporation will purchase the land and we will go to develop the area. The fund was 500 million given by Japan government to...
Pero nag-ano na ba? Namaterialize na ba yan? May nabili na kayo na lupa?
Nagawa na po namin, sir, at occupied na. Okay. We have 109 sa Dilay, that is already occupied. And 120 sa Dilay West, that is also occupied, Mr. Chair. And we have 438 in Patani. That is, the housing unit was already built and completed by UN Habitat. However, the development, Mr. Chair, particularly on the roads, drainage, water, and electrical, is included on the contractor amount, sir. The budget was included and we're not rely on LUA or whatever. We have estimated the cost of putting centralized deep well for water system. And the electrical is Nasoreco. All budget was included on the contract of contractor, Mr. Chair. However, on the installation of water system, pipes were already laid. Pipes, distribution pipe within the subdivision, Mr. Chair, was already laid. However, completion of it is delayed because of the problem on the road right of way that we cannot, the construction materials supposed to be built for to be constructed or replaced in the site of Patani was not passable as your right of way, sir.
Ganito na lang. Can you submit to us your problems, yung challenges for right to, road right of way? Ano ba yung sinabi mo?
Wala na, sir. Yun lang ang problem natin sa SOCA. May install na natin pati yung electrical post pagka yung ating daan sa right of way.
Patani yan, Patani. Congressman Rodge, you have a follow-up. That's a satisfying question.
Mr. Chair, apologies po. Iba'y additional information siguro po. Pero yung confusion po namin as an outsider, I'm curious lang po kasi kung ilang houses na po yung meron, ilang ba yung gagawin, and how many po talaga yung needed. I don't know po if the metrics po kasi ng internal displaced persons is per head or per household. Pero I just had to bring this up kasi of note po, Mr. Chair, when si Congressman Emmanuel was asking kung sapat na po yun, there was dissent po. Sinasabi po hindi daw sapat. I registered some dissent po from the persons, from our stakeholders here. Yeah. So I just had to ask po kung sapat na po yun.
Yeah. Mr. Chair, I second, Mr. Chair, I too heard. And hopefully that they will be given time later. At the same time, Mr. Chair, that they will be given a time later to speak, Mr. Chair. So we'll be able to hear from them, Mr. Chair, then the complaints or the needs of
Marawi, Mr. Chair. Anyway, this is what we're going to do because we are working on a very tight schedule here. So I would like to request NHA and maybe you can give us your report, and including the one that you said that there was a problem with the road right away.
Yes, sir.
Provide us with and Asen Castro, I think the question of Congressman Gutierrez is how many IDPs, the units, how many do you have the matrix based on your listing? How many IDPs are still in need of units? How many units have we provided? Where are these shelters? Are these units under the temporary shelter arrangement or the permanent shelter arrangement? So can you give us the list?
We can provide the list.
Thank you. Thank you. Congressman Rodriguez, would that satisfy your question?
Mr. Chair, in the meantime, it's still satisfactory. So yung tanong lang naman po, Mr. Chair, is kung sapat. And if it will be satisfactorily answered by the good ASEC and through the NHA, then this representation will likewise will be satisfied. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, Chief Congressman.
With the additional information, I was also curious. There were problems mentioned ka kanina na may mga road right-of-way problems, pero there were also some good reports naman na may nalagay na na pipes and all other installations, no? May completion na rin ng partial completion ng mga housings. Is it also possible siguro na at least for the sake of transparency and to be able to look into the trends, kung ano ba yung progress natin, pwede din ba na samahan na natin yun ng budgetary component? So at least na amount that was promised or amount that was granted vis-a-vis yung amount that was already utilized. Para at least na makita din natin if on track tayo sa pag-fulfill ng 100% completion ng mga projects na.
The reason why we're here is not to find faults on anyone, okay? I want you to be as honest as possible. This is a no holds barred. You can say anything. That's why we're here. We want to help you out, NHA. We want to help you with the budget. Whatever that you may want us to do sa budget. So just tell us, just be honest with us. Kasi masyado na pong matagal tayo nagpapabilik hearing. Ito, no holds barred po dito. Nasabihin po natin, do we have DSUD here? DSUD. Department of DSUD?
Human Settlement.
No. I want to put this on record, Your Honors, that there's also a problem in terms of paying for the local contractors, those who built the mosques, local mosques here. They have not been paid. And I learned from I think, if I'm not mistaken, from Mayor, that there's a problem with the payment. And the money there really is a donation, it's a private donation. I want to find out from DSUD if they still have that money. And you need to pay these people. They have built the mosque, you need to pay these people. Wala ba tayong DSUD dito? Wala. Asi, can you inform that?
Yes, sir. We will advise DSUD representative that this was brought out during the meeting.
Thank you. So any other questions or issues regarding housing? Wala. So let's move for proceed with Laso Rico. By the way, Laso Rico, we just approved your condonation.
Yeah.
We just approved that. We are asking sa Senate. All of this, ito pong mga kasama ko dito, sumuporta po sa condonation.
Ha?
Pakasabihin niyo po, ilan lang po kami, no? It's an effort by the House of Representatives under Speaker Martin Romualdez. And I'm sure we will lobby for the Senate for a version of the Senate para mas matatas na po. Laso Rico, I know you just started your job a couple of weeks ago. I have given that benefit of the doubt, but maybe you can give us maybe a short update on how can we solve the problem of energizing. Meron pong substation dyan sa Tagungan. Ayaw pong i-energize ng NGCP because of the debt, yung utang. But what plans do you have to move further, Laso Rico?
Sir, in the case of the power substation in Tagungan, that is 2 TB. As you have mentioned, there is a problem. So, recently, we wrote a letter to the Vice President of the NGCP to fulfill the requirement they are requesting. By June 14, pupunta po kami ng Manila with the EGM resource to know. Bigay kami ng GK at 3 million monthly up to December. That is one of the requirements. So I think kapag na-fulfill natin yan, pwede na i-energize. Although there are minor corrections. Galing kami doon hapon with the new EGM. So tinignan namin yung substation. So in the case of the distribution line, nakita niyo naman, lahat ng shelter, permanent and temporary, mayroon na pong ilaw. In the case of ground zero, yung underground cable, I think that was awarded to Itmari Construction. We were told by the previous management that hindi pa daw natulogir sa Laso Rico niyan. Although, ready for renovation or
Ano po hindi na-turnover sa Laso Rico? Yung ground cable?
Oo.
Pero nandiyan na po yung mga equipments?
Yes.
Okay.
So isa pa sir, Mr. Chair, who's the contractor again?
I think Edmari. Alam po ni Asik Bilic.
Sino daw?
ABC Asik.
Edmari.
And supposedly, when be turned over?
Pag kung kumulito na yan.
No, the contract will have a date of start and a date of completion.
Yeah.
Kailan dapat yung date of completion?
Ay, sa ano lang nila ito magiging nasi at bago ipasa sa cooperative.
NHA. Ito ground zero to ha?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
The underground cable, sir, is part of the road project and we have already turned it over to the city government with regards to the primary loan. So we're just waiting for the city government to turn it over to Lasoneco.
Mr. Chair, it's getting to be a little bit complicated. Would it be possible again, Mr. Chair, for the gentleman to submit a written report? And if there will be 5 pages, Mr. Chair, to sign all the 5 pages, Mr. Chair, so that we will be able to study it better, we will be able to read it better, and we will be able to ask them during the hearing on the, in the House of Representatives, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Well, NHA, again, we would like you to submit this document, sir. And kasi ang tinitingnan po natin dyan, once we start the integration, the consumption of electric power will spike. Imagine yung mga tao dyan, babalik. So, the demand for power supply will spike, tataas po yan. So, we have to be ready on that. And then, case number two, ang gusto ko lang ipa-ano sa Lasoneco is dyan sa amin, yung my hometown, the Jan Ramayan, all the way to Pasio, Pasac area. Single phase yan. Hindi yung makataruman yan. Bawal na ho ang single phase na yun. Dapat 3 phases yan eh. Full, no? So, nasisira po yung mga appliances namin dyan. Hindi yung kami makabili ng refrigerator kasi nasisira. On and off ang electric power dyan sa my first district dyan po sa pinakaano ko, sa Basag area. Nag-usap po kami with Dea Almeida. And he promised me, sabi nga, may nagsabi ko sila sa amin, nagagawa na nila. The problem is because of the transmission line. Now, I think we need to work on that. We need to work on that with NGCP. Kasi hindi yung kami papayag. There are mayors in some town there, in that area, I will not mention their names, asking me if I can file for a mandatory bill to separate them from the franchise area. Because they want to connect with Bukidnon. Kasi ayaw na nila ang performance ng Lasoneco kasi nga single phase daw. So before we reach that stage, because that would constitute also, ito GM for your information, that would also constitute probably plebiscito eh. You don't necessarily disenfranchise some portions under the franchise area, but you also ask the people. But this is something that we have to look forward to. These are the challenges. And I'm sure you're up to that challenges because you took over Lasoneco, despite the fact that there's so many problems, and you know this. So what do you intend to do with that?
Sir, you're welcome. Right now, four engineers from the have was with me yesterday. Sabi ko, para po, tingnan lang lahat mo kung ano po yung problema. So, sabi po sa amin ni Administrator Almeida is that kapigay ka agad ng report so that we can mapasunta po yung mga problema. So, yun ang nga po ang ginagawa namin. That's why yung pong apat na engineers mo na dito para tingnan lang po yung lahat.
Ganito po, GM.
Opo.
You can, pag-assume ko ng office, you can come to my office.
Yes, sir.
I work on it. I think si Leida Adea, Apresito naman, is open naman eh. Okay. And you have a champion in the House of Representatives in the person of Percy, Congressman Percy and Congressman Sergio Dabobo. Tutulong lang sila eh. We have to work on that because pag bumalik po ang mga tao dyan ng standing compensation ruling at may tubig na po dyan, problema niyo po kuryente. Even yung supply ng tubig, kailangan ng kuryente. Lahat po titingin yan pag walang kuryente. Hindi po natin ayaw po natin mangyari yan. So I hope you can, and can you also provide this committee your plans on how to move forward with Lasoneco?
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. And can you give us maybe your board resolution, maybe requesting probably the Senate to file for a separate version of the coordination act.
Yes, sir.
Kasi support ito ng
solution.
So any other questions on electric power? Yeah. Asik, I'm sorry Asik, always ikaw ang pinahuli ko kasi ikaw yung patagal na nandito. Ano pa yung mga concerns na hindi pa namin na-mention, Asik, in terms of electric power? Again, I want you to be honest with us. Gusto namin problema ang marinig namin. Kasi problema ho talaga dapat ang i-face natin para may solusyon. Asik.
Yung underground facilities, matagal nang sinatrabaho ng Ed Maria, NHA, and Lasureco. Siguro kailangan nyo lang tanungin dun sa sino ba yung tauhan ng Lasureco ang nagke-testing because pinapatesting niya last time at final stages na sila para ma-update kayo kung ano yung latest dun sa testing ng underground cable. Yun lang siya.
Okay, thank you. Pero itong underground na kasi narinig ko rin yung underground cable. Tingnan natin NHA, tingnan natin yung documents and then maybe we can sit down with Lasureco. Tingnan natin.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Do you have any other updates?
Wala na po.
Okay. Kailangan yung...
Yes. Pinabot mo lang. Pati yung kuryente sa Patani. Ano bang update doon? Ginergil bang?
We have requested na the money was already downloaded to us amounting to 3 million. That is the three-phase connection from Abraham Road going to Patani site of the Social Housing Finance Corporation project. Now, we are constantly talking with your people, sir, mga engineers ninyo, with regards to the memorandum, government to government lang, para may transfer namin yung 3 million, para masimulan ninyo yung connection. Pero ang problema, as a Castro, Mr. Chair, is yung nag-back down na box culvert at kailangan palitan para makatawid tayo.
Ano yung?
Yung kanina minensyo.
Culvert?
Yes, sir.
Ito ba asik yung sinasabi mo kanina?
Yes, sir. Yan po yung problema namin sa...
Kaninong project nyo?
Actually, wala pang project yan, but we endorse it to DPWH kasi for construction na kailangan na ng tulay. So we propose na DPWH included ito.
Mickey, makabantok. Do you have a microphone there? Sa planning study. Sa plan. Pero na-request ito ng DPWH region 10, no? Wala pa? Okay, wala pa. Anyway, nag-usap-usap naman tayo kanina asik with ano. So yun ang problema mo kahit yung mag-proceed yung project.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Pati yun, sir, yung completion na nating drainage, water, and electrical inside ni Patani, sir.
So, bigyan mo na lang kami ng ano nyo. Kasi yun din ang actually yung sinabi sa akin ni Engineer Mickey ng planning ng RR ng ano. Gusto nila mag... We will work on that, but we need your data, we need your documents for that. Ha?
Okay. Thank you, Mr.
Thank you. So, this is connection with the electric power in Patani. Asik, no? Yung sinasabi po niya.
Yes, sir. At saka, Mr. Chair, yung completion ng electrification within the subdivision noong ating North Salam Village sa Patani ay hindi rin makakonect yung mga Lasureco ng poste dahil yung kanilang equipment na magbabaon ng poste hindi rin makatawid. Kaya necessity po talaga yung...
Pero dapat part yan ng budget ninyo. Paano nyo lagyan yan ng ano? Yung lupa ba? Mamalambot?
No, sir. Yung equipment lang, sir, na maglalagay na from Lasureco ang problema. Hindi makatawid kasi nga yung...
Walang kasada.
Yung tulay nga, sir, na
nagpapakot. Okay. Anyway, nandiyan si Mickey, on record naman siya. So, nirequest lang namin yun, ha? Thank you. So, any questions from the members?
Ayaw. Okay. Ayaw ko nali. Ayaw.
Look na, sway. And I spring and tan. May mga animal rights advocates dito.
Okay, mabuna lang.
Yes.
In the case of the low voltage issue in the Barsad area, inumpisa na po namin. So, yung iba, okay na. So, pinasok namin yung lahat ng linya dyan, including the lateral. We found out that there are some lines there without neutral line. So, inaano na namin yan. Kung hindi pa na energies yung doting ni, like for example, the three towns in the second district, Bote, Dubay Nagi, at Dumalundo, 40 volt, ang ano niyan, 40 volts lang. Pero ngayon,
alam ko, ayos na. Alam ko ba pa yung transmission line ng Bote ng German gagaling din, connected sa Masyo, di ba?
Yes, but di ba i-disconnect
na? Sa area din.
I-disconnect na namin. We,
tapit to the Ganasi substation. Kaya gumanda yung kultay nila. Ngayon, ang problema dyan sa distribution line, with to Basakiria, nakikita niya naman yung poste lang yung nakatay dyan. The line that is to be rehabilitated or new construction, hindi po natapos hanggang ngayon. That started 2021.
Ano yan? Anong hindi natapos? Transmission?
Distribution line. Yeah.
So po si sino po yung gumagawa niya tapos?
Na-release na sa kumpiyan, pero inano sa kontraktor. So, we found out na parang iniwan na kontraktor. The problem now is, pina-extend nila yung duration of time of the project. Hindi na-renew yung mga performance bonus.
Ganito, isa, GM, i-request na lang namin yung sinasabi po ni Bapasadik Lauhan. Request po ito. So, ang priority niyo po ganito. Una, yung energy, pag-energize dyan sa Basakiria. Okay? And I can help you with that. Tutulong po kami. Labi po tayo sa NGCP kung po pwede. Then number two, kasi kailangan i-anticipate mo yung pagbabalik ng tao dyan. Kasi kailangan talaga natin sa nasa 17, di ba? Megawatts na pa. So, kundi lang yung gagamitin natin. So, pwede po pati pabigay nyo lang po yung data nyo sa amin. Ha? So, we can work on it. No? Again, I'd like to wish you good luck, GM, sa ano po. So, any other concerns po with the electric power? Now, we move on to the most essential, one of the most essential, water. What are the problems po, GM, Rash Tietyong?
Mr. Chair, nakita na po natin yung paan yung site ng Bukweter. Ang problema lang po, natin na yung contractor ka because of the problem of the land. Ngayon, may proposal po na ilipat nila yung lalagyan ng reservoir at saka yung treatment plant. But then I informed the lower representative na yung lilipat na nila is mababa yung elevation. Now, that's why we propose the side on the upper side kasi yun ang pinakamataas na elevation. Pag inilipat po yun sa ibaba, i-drive po natin yung tubig sa maa na mas mataas. So, kung pwede lang po is doon na lang ituloy yung paglalagyan. Kasi pag inilipat po yan, mababa na po yung elevation na lalagyan ng reservoir. So, kung maaari lang, doon na lang sa original design, is mas maganda po.
So, para for the information of everyone, dalawa po ito pinag-usapan natin na yung backwater system sa taas, sa kampo, dyan sa Old City Hall. Tapos meron po tayong pag-ilalagyan dyan ng treatment, sewage treatment facilities sa baba. Ang tanong ko po una, ilan ba talaga ang lupa kailangan ninyo? Yung actual na lupa kailangan po ng water district para mapalagyan. Kasi darating ko si Secretary Ibo tsaka si Secretary Nasir Pangandaban nag-usap-usap po kami. Incremental yung downloading yung ng fund based on the actual accomplishment or actual na pumasok na tao.
So phase 2 po yung sunod, may 100 million pa po kami. We're planning to expand yung capacity ng treatment plant kasi mas in-expect pa namin mas dadami yung tao sa...
Pwede malaman yung treatment plant, yung mismo, yung pinaka-base niya.
Apo.
Yung ilang square meter. Then, yung reservoir natin, kung gano'ng kalaki.
Apo.
Kasi kung 5,000, ang lalagyan natin, kasi laki ng jeep.
Medyo malaki po talaga.
Medyo malaki. Ilang litro ba yan? Sa isang
5 mL muna, but we're planning to expand it up to 15 mL. Megaliters per day. So, mga 15 million liters per day.
15 million?
Apo.
Liters?
Yes, sir.
Then, kung gagawin yung tanke niya, yung base niya, ilang square meter ba?
Yung base sa study po namin, 5,000 po for the para ma-expand siya into that. So,
hindi, kasi ganito, no? Ang problema, ang laki-laki ng hinihingi natin, pero hindi magkasundo. Dahil ayaw na AFP, nabigyan tayo ng ganun. Kasi gusto nila, every 25 years, i-re-renew natin yan. Nagbigay na tayo, magbibigay na rin tayo ng 25% discount. Usapan na yan. In fact, napirmahan na yan ng manager ng Marawi Water District, yung dating administrator ng LUA at ang AFP, na ang ibibigay lang ng Water District is 25% sa bayan nila, discount. Then yung renewable, wala na ho yun. Kaya ngayon, bumalik na naman na magkakaroon ng 25 years. Every 25 years, i-renew. Ngayon, kung hindi ma-renew yan, ang magtatanggal ang Marawi Water District sa lahat ng facilities doon. Then, kung sa ngayon, magkano yung pera available?
Sabi niyo po ay for the bulk supply, nandiyan naman po, although hindi pa nada-download yung MCA, but 160
million,
yes, total. For the phase 1. Tapos yung phase 2, binigyan na rin po kami ng SARO for the 100 million. So after may implement ng phase 1, so we're hoping implement namin yung phase
2. Sabihin na natin 300 million yan. Ang problema, after 25 years, i-renew. Kung hindi pa renew yan, by the time na 25 years na yun, magkano yung 300 million equivalent dun sa after 25? Baka umabot na tayo ng 3 billion. Saan kukuha ang Marawi and Lana del Sur? Gumawa na naman ulit na yung lalagyan natin ng tangke for 3 billion. Eh wala nga tayong lupa eh. Bakit hindi pa pwede? Hindi po pwede yung lupa na yon ibigay na lang sa Water District. Alam natin na sa AFP yan. Alam natin yan. 10 hectares na yan. 5,000 lang ang hinihingi natin. Yun nga yung sinasuggest na yung 5,000, pwede naman kami kumulong ni Mayor na bilhin din through doon sa program na yan. Kasi hindi natin kaya kung yung lupa, bibili na lang ng, alam mo, mahal ngayon. Pwede naman siguro ibawas, ipartition yung 5,000 doon sa 10,000, 10 hectares na yan. Yung 10 hectares is equivalent to 100,000 square meters. Ano ba naman yung 5,000 na ibigay sa ano? Una-una, kaya mangyayari yan, kaya ibigay dahil sa maa. Ngayon, after 25 years, magiging ganun. Ako po, hindi ko kayang iiwan sa pamilya ko yung ganun. After 25 years, pagdating ng 25 years, ako ang sisisihin ng tao. Ang sisisihin nila, yung mga anak ko. Kasi, by the time ng 25 years, baka patay na ako nun. Hindi na akong buhay. Kaya ayokong iwanan sa mga anak ko, mga pamilya ko, yung sisi.
Mr. Chair?
Yes,
what I understand about the installation of the camp, Mr. Chair, is dahil po sa seeds, kaya nilagyan nila yan ang kampo. But then, the water system also, the construction of the bulk water is a part of the rehabilitation of Marawi. So, yung ang sabi ng mga tao, mas maigi wala kaming ilaw kaysa wala kaming tubig. Sana
lahat dalawa meron. So, ay tama. Well, I guess NUWA, may mga position ng NGO ng province na ito, born out from the discussion we had inside the poster, proposal ni ano. The NGO, I think, as far as the province is concerned, and we can discuss this over with Mayor Paul Gandamra, and I'm sure he's willing, on the part, the aspect of the expropriation, the actual payment for the expropriation, maybe the party can shoulder that, and they're entertaining that option. But I guess the NUWA, darating si Secretary Ibok, Secretary Nasser, kasi may marching order si President Bongbong Marcos na dapat matapos na ang rehabilitation ng Barawi kasi it's over 6 years. And ayaw niya, by the time na mag-midterm election, tapos pinag-uusapan pa natin ang rehabilitation. So, darating siya, I want Lua, you have to be there. And also, so I'm sure si GM Rashdi Adyong will also be there, the governor and the mayor. So we will discuss this over. Darating din ng OSG. I went to Secretary Kibo, where's General Barongquillo? For the information, yes, General, I went to Secretary Kibo 3 months ago. Nag-usap kami in person with the OSG representative and ask him if possible na balikan yung tripartite memorandum of agreement nung time na si GTA pa si CSAP Broner. No? Si General Broner is very much aware of the situation, the dynamics on the ground because he has been our PD for some time, your predecessor. So alam ko may mga legal implications in effect. Kasi the position of OSGs, if it's going to be built within the military camp, it should be exclusively used by the military alone. So our position kasi namin is that the camp was envisioned not before the siege, but after the siege. The camp, the plan for to build a camp is an after effect. After the fact, no? Kung ano nangyari sa siege. So I think that's the thing that we need to solve and resolve para makabalik na po, mag-start na po yung ano. 30% yung ba, luwa, ulang matapos nila?
Actually, nung nandumin po tayo sa Senate, nung ano?
Yeah, 60 I remember.
Na, 60 na po actually. So yung planta na lang at yung reservoirs, na-lay na namin yung pipe, yung intake structure is already ready. But of course, anytime na bigyan kami ng go signal, our contractors are ready to resume.
Same contractor sa?
Yes po, yes.
Nandiyan pa yung pondo?
Nandiyan pa, wala po.
Pero by December, tama po ba? By December 19 matapos i-revert yung pondo, tama po ba? Is it may correct pero?
Hindi pa po ako aware. Pero I'll...
Can you check on that? Kasi may narinig ako eh. Ayoko bumala yung pondo sa revert yan.
So, yun po. As soon na bibigyan po kami ng go signal na matapos po yung...
Yes. Si General ang mag-uusap sa amin, General, sa 1-3 na tayo waiting
na. There is a plan, Your Honor, that the Secretary will visit on Friday, but nothing is final. Anyway po, ASEC Ramos is coming. Delay na po because of issues sa mga helicopter. And I asked the Governor of that meeting, even after the hearing, said, ASEC Ramos and the Governor will talk about this para mabigyan nila ng initial background ng series. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much, General. But in the meantime, Luwang, can you give us your status report?
Yes. I will send it to your office.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Any other concerns when it comes to water sa mga Your Honors? Wala? Okay. So we will keep po. Pasensya na po ha. Again, we are not faulting anyone. Ano ba kami sisir para tutuway tanong? Yes, mo tanong siya yung public hearing. Kung public hearing na position paper, ito mo namin na kaliritsyon. Yan, hindi na yan tanong man tanong mag-public hearing. Ito na yung pag-inita na ito na yung problema. Ito na yung solution tanong. So, well, ha? Well, so, ang na mga designated ko mga CSOs, mga tao, so mga stakeholders, si Saya, relay kami niyo, ni Ms. Ganong Kabugan sa oras, o itong isa na ano, pagkakakano po sa at least representative. Sulista ang tanong na ayan si Seam, pero na si Governor Adyong, si Mayor Mahul Gandamra, sino pa ba? Yung ABC President, pero he will be represented by the wife, the current barangay captain of Dato Sadat Salam. Maybe si Governor Adyong, nasabi na niya ata yung piece niya kanina. Oh, would you like to come up later before we proceed with the mapabanking?
Ito lang itagdag, no, yung okay na tayo sa water, yung sa housing. Yung sa housing kasi may MOA, under MOA sa provincial government, which is 750 units. Natapos na namin yung 600. Siguro, before pa Before papapasok si President Marcos, natapos na yun. Ngayon, yung 150, hindi pa nada-download para tapusin yun. Kasi yung site dev natin, site dev, tapos na. Kaya ang kulang na lang yung 150 units.
Thank you, Governor Diok. Hindi, pasalitahin muna natin yung mga LGUs. The mayor will be equally represented by his father-in-law, the city administrator, Ambassador Macabangkit Lanto. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, Governors. Bilisan lang po ito, dahil tapos tayo sa oras. We just want to go on the record. The appreciation and the profound gratitude of SGU Islamic City of Marawi for your visit for conducting a local inspection at nakita ko ninyo ang mga problema at sana yung masolusyon ng agad ang mga problema dito. Tama po si Congressman, ako na yung mga Maranao dito sa Marawi at sa Kalirao, Desu, ay maswerte. At pero kami anak na Congressman na talagang wala na siyang iniisip kundi ang kapakanan ng kanyang albusan, pananalian, hapunan ay iniisip kung paano makatulong sa mabilisang rehabilitation ng Marawi City at madaliang pagbayad sa compensation. Nakita po namin ang inyayin-init at saka buong-buang suporta ninyo kay Congressman Zia. Natatandaan ko po ay recall the days when I and Congressman Mamindang Mike Adyong Sr., the namesake of Bundi, when we were in the 9th Congress, sponsoring the conversion of the Landa Provincial Hospital into a may pangpap medical center, nagkanta po kami ng public hearing dito, wala kami nahilang Congressman, kundi si Honore Ramiro ng Osamis Bambi. Yun pala, kaya kasi punta, depawin na siya, kaya sumama na lang sa amin dito. Nakagilap po dahil ang dami rin nag-i-sponsor ng team. Hindi namin alam ni Mike na marami rin nag-i-sponsor yung conversion din ng kanilang hospital into a medical center. Kaya kami nagpapasalamat, siguro hindi masyadong importante sa inyo ito, pero itong malaking bagay, ang inyong presence, ang makita namin kayo dito ay malaking bagay sa mga Maranao dito, kapag we have confirmed that you, Congressman of Kenya, have in your heart the welfare and the speedy rehabilitation of Marawi and the speedy payment of the compensation for the victim. Yun lang po at sana balik kayo ulit ito para yung mga problema na pag-usapan at ito, madali ang solusyon. Lalo na ito si Bambi na kapunta, kaya relative natin ito, Prabuato. So maraming salamat po. Wabilahin ka upay kwalaydaya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Walaikum salam. Thank you very much, Mapabangi, former congressman of Congressman Macabangkit Lanto. Babalik po kami, hindi ito yung last na, I think hindi ito yung last. Babalik po kami dito. Si Ma'am Geraldine, si Kong Mix, talaga lahat po kami, babalik po kami dito, inshallah. So, we will have just an assurance po, Macabangkit, just an assurance to the mayor that this committee will stand side by side with the LGU now to make sure that completion of Marawi City will be finalized within the term of the president of this current administration, President Bongbong Marcos. That I can assure you, inshallah. With the help, of course, of all the stakeholders. So, we would like to hear from the barangay chairman of Datum Sanan Salan, Dayanara Rasuman. Do I feel the current ABC? I think sa mga pagdating ng mga gobyerno ng mga barangay chairman diyan po sa MAA, kung may position po kami, position paper po kayo, you can send them to papers, you can send them to the committee. And in the meantime, baka saan po pwede natin pakinggan, no, para with expediency of time. Yes, Ms. Rasuman, please.
Yes, good afternoon. Ang appeal lang po namin is to fast-track the compensation, no? Para hindi na ma-prolong ang agony ng mga constituents namin kasi hindi pa sila nakakabalik until now. Nasa temporary shelters pa rin sila. So, yung iba naman, hirap talaga sa buhay. So, kailangan talaga nila itong compensation. Kasi so more than one year na yung inantay ng mga victims. Kasi more than one year na yung pag-interview sa kanila. So, yun lang po yung namin, fast track ang compensation.
Thank you. Yung issue po ng compensation, we have decided to separate that. Because that requires thorough analysis and how we go about with all the problems. And the compensation is actually, the discussion of the compensation will be a joint committee between the Senate and the House of Representatives. Ito po yung sa House. Pagdating po sa compensation, may joint oversight po ang Senate and ano. But rest assured kasi alam po namin na well-connected ang compensation sa rehabilitation. So we are dealing these two separate issues. One is the rehabilitation now. This is the reason why we're holding this public consultation. And the other one is the compensation. But in the coming days, I will be speaking with Chairman Maysara of Damon Latif along with the members of the board. And I will also sit down with the members of the CSOs so that we can finally agree on certain terms. Kasi nagkakaproblema po doon sa understanding ng valuation. I think Ambassador Lato was there during a joint meeting. Valuation standard, that's the problem.
Yes, Chairman, you on the preparation committee that there was a consensus for us to ask for a joint resolution conference in order to amend some provisions of the compensation law, because according to the compensation board, their hands are tied. I mean, if they strictly follow the law, the remainder will be paid to the victims. So that the concessions we have arrived at a fortnight ago in that joint committee meeting was to ask for a joint resolution of Congress. And the Sangguniang Pangkonsul of Marawi City has passed a resolution, Your Honor. Supporting the move to call for a joint resolution of Congress to amend the law in order to give a leeway to the opposition board to do what is right and what is just.
Yeah, that is correct. I agree po, Ambassador Lato. Actually, those are one of the things that we discussed during the joint oversight committee. We will revisit the law. And then we will possibly file for an amendatory bill in order that we can adjust the valuation standard now being utilized by MCB kasi tight po yung kamay nila. But rest assured, we will do that. Senator Bato de la Rosa has already confirmed to the body that he will file for the Senate part, and I will file a separate also amendatory bill in the House of Representatives, and I'm sure all of this, my colleagues here present, tandaan niyo po ito kasi baka may magna-national po sa kanila. Sila po yung pumunta sa atin dito, maski celebrate, celebrate, break po natin. Sila po yung pumunta dito, may mga baso, tandaan niyo po sila yung mga pangalan nila. Baka po may mag-senador dito. At mas qualify po sila maging senador. These are hard-working congressmen, and I'm sure all of them will be in support of the amendatory bill that we will file. Ambassador Lato. So thank you very much for that information. Thank you for reminding this committee that we have discussed that also. So the last person to speak is a representative of the Women IDPs. Ito, Ma'am Geraldine, Women IDPs. Siya ang chairman ng Women and Gender Equality. Chairperson ng committee. Miss as Naomi Macabando, representing the women IDPs of Marawi. Ma'am, you have 2 minutes po. Meron po kayong position paper dyan?
Wala po. Kumus lang po namin.
Sige. But thank you. I'll give you mga 2 to 3 minutes. Thank you.
Opo. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh po. Kami po yung mga women sector po from different temporary shelters po ng Marawi City. Yung i-update ko po sa inyo is yung current situation po namin sa mga temporary shelters po. Ngayon, nagbabayad po kami o nag-re-rent po kami sa aming mga shelter, sa mga owners po, land owners ng mga shelters. Nagbabayad din po kami ng ilaw, 300 to 800 po. Sabi nga namin, nais po namin umapila doon po sa social housing po. Sana po mabigyan kami ng pabahay din po. Kasi po, kung MCB po yung antay po namin, may mga kasamaan na po kami na namatay. Hindi na po umabot sa MCB. Ang tanong din po, anong amount po ba na makukuha namin? Enough po ba yun para itayo namin yung mga bahay namin sa ground zero? Hindi po. Di po ba? Alhamdulillah, at saka po, kami po ay nagpapatulong sa inyo na mabigyan po kami ng sustainable livelihood po. Unang-unang po yung employment po, para po may opportunity po yung mga young people po na magkaroon po ng trabaho. May nakatapos po na mga yun na until now hindi pa po naka-ano sa trabaho. At saka kami po ng mga women po, kami po idol po namin kayo ma'am, sa totoo lang. Kami po, marunong din po kami mag-counterpart. Turuan niyo po kami tumayo sa sarili namin mga paa.
Mr. Chair, yes. Nagtitake note po kami ninyong comments. In fact, dun sa usapin nga na kayo ngayon ay nagbabayad ng rent,
yes,
at saka ilaw dahil nag-lapse na po yung 5 years na palugit ng landowners. Nag-take note po kami nun at ito po ang dahilan kung bakit mapadaliin na po namin sa Kongreso nitong budget season yung pag-release ng war funds. Ano po. But doon po sa usapin ng social housing, iba po sa pinag, I don't think that's also covered by the Marat.
For the information of Congresswoman Roman, ang nagpag-usapan po namin ni Cherky Cominites is the chairman of Urban Planning and Development. Sa housing siya, we will conduct a joint committee hearing. Kasi sabi ko, kailangan mo ng tulong because the problem of Marawi City really is so complex that hindi kaya ng isang ad hoc committee lang. I need support from other standing committees. So, kumayag si Chairman Kiko Benitez. As soon as we resume session, upo kami and he will fix the housing problem. Maraming salamat din po kay Kiko Benitez. On the part of the, pati yung water actually. So, yung sa housing na nyo, yung problema po ninyo ng housing. Kasi rent ang problema po ninyo, no?
Opo.
Subsidy. Subsidy. And maybe we can discuss that. But right now, I think nakuha na namin po yung sentimento ninyo na narinig po namin. We will look for a possible, yes.
Yes. At saka yun nga po sa usapin na kung sapat ba yung compensation na binigay sa inyo. Aware din po kami, napakinggan namin kayo kanina, hindi po talaga. Yun na po yung pinag-uusapan namin kung talaga maging patay sa fair market value or a little bit more, no? Kasi sa ibang transaksyon, ibang pamantayan ang ginagamit. So we have taken note of that. And then the last point that she raised is yung usapin na livelihood. Meron akong bubulok para sa test the horses para po sa mga women and youth of Marawi who want to earn a living. Around 7 million pesos magbababa ko ng test the horses.
Thank you very much, Geraldine. Ito po yung rason mo bakit yung sila pumunta dito kasi gusto talaga nilang tumulong. But anyway, on record na po yung sinabi niyo, if you have position to forget, bigyan niyo lang po sa amin. At hindi ka matapos?
Well, hindi pa, sir.
Oh, paano ka maagad? Ano mo kumplay nila?
Well, pag meron na pinalamata ng kasi, sir, so kayo, hospital, wala ka na. Kaya ako, kung mga, spano kay sir, go. Sa mga liwa, Mr. Hospital. Uli minig, sir. Niya, mga bandong panaligan po. Ito ba, baka tingin na kami niyo, hindi din pa kapiya sa pagbiging tawa, hindi kami makatitingin na, hindi kami makakitingin o kama na, hindi kami nangyayang pura walay. Kaya karagilingan na, pamimigilan naman kita, nagpamimigilan naman na, ang taan na kami work, saan po kami kukuha ng pangrenta, kung makabayad po kami ng renta sa bahay, hindi po kami makabayad sa inaw. Kung makabayad man po kami sa inaw, hindi po kami makarenta. Kapag na ano na po, nasa may shelter na po kami, na matatawag na decent housing po, yung utak namin po, makaka-focus po talaga yan sa pag-aanap buhay namin. Makaka-focus yan sa pamilya namin, lalo-lalo yung mga anak namin na nag-aanap.
Yes, thank you very much. I think this is the reason why we're asking NHA, kasi part of your problem really is housing. And thank you very much for sharing that to us, for very candid about your emotions. And we sympathize with you. Ako po, I depended po ako. But I would admit that I am, compared to many, I am more lucky and fortunate na IDP. And I thank God for that. And this is the reason why I'm here, because you chose me as your representative to voice to the national government what are the problems that we are encountering today. So, salamat. If you have questions, NHA, narinig mo naman po si ma'am. So, I think also, but may sinabi po kanina si chairman, chairwoman na daw, si ma'am Geraldine na about that. So, baka makatulong din po yun sa test. Sa next. So, thank you very much po, ma'am, for...
Isa lang po. Okay. Si Samantalay ko lang po kasi hindi po kami makapunta ng Manila. Wala po kami budget. Ma'am, yung ano po, upgrade po, enterprise. Mag-invest po tayo dito sa Marawi City. Para din po yan sa amin, sa mga kabataan. Kung okay, may private sector po, mag-invest po kayo. Dali dito yung Jollibee. May curlot po tayo, may boss cafe po. Para din po yan sa mga kabataan. Di po ba?
Well,
yes, kasi po naniniwala po ako, kahit konti lang yung kaalaman ko, naniniwala po ako na hindi kaya, hindi kaya kanwa ng government natin, lalo na dito sa Marawi City, na makapag-trabaho yung mga kabataan natin, lalo na yung mga young professional po. Baka po dyan, makatulong din po sa amin.
Thank you very much, ha?
Thank you
for the point. Actually, yung portion na sinabi po niya, although yung Jollibee po, depende po yan kung sino mag-invest ng pera. Pero meron na po tayong pure gold dito, and it's a sign that we are progressing. I think yung sinasabi mo, yung microfinance and entrepreneur lang, kasi marami pong self-employed dito sa amin. And these are mostly about yung mga our traditional handcrafts, yung mga malong, yung mga ano. I think pinuproof ko nga rin ito sa testa. We have an alternative way of helping them out. Kasi this is a technology and expertise that passed on from generation to generation. And by promoting this industry, we are also in a way preserving the culture of a certain group of people. So baka po pwede na, that's one of the areas that we are still looking at. Thank you very much. So, Your Honors, meron pong gustong magsalita na isa lang. Kung okay lang po sa inyo, you still have time?
Yeah, Mr. Chair. Just very short, Mr. Chair.
Yes, Chair.
I listened to the gentle lady, nakinig po ako sa kanya. At saka, doon sa sustainable livelihood, two cents worth, Mr. Chair. Kung pwede doon sa joint na balak nyo, isama nyo si Congressman Christian Bonabia, chairman ng SME sa Mr. Chair. May photo doon eh, na pwede kayong umiram ng pera, pwede mahiram yung Mr. Chair. And Mr. Chair, kasi isa na lang, I actually have a motion, Mr. Chair, and Chino, I need a second. Mr. Chair, I may move, Mr. Chair, that these three committees, the committees on housing, water, and electricity, will submit a report in the House of Representatives every quarter. Same data. So we will be able to compare, assess on how we are doing in every quarter. A suggestion of Congroman so that we will be able to do more for you. Diba? Parang every 3 months, magsasubmit sila ng report. Pag-compare namin, oh, ba't walang nangyari dito? So alam natin kung anong problema at pwede natin mahanapan ng paraan. So move, Mr. Chair.
Second, Mr. Chair. Standing, hearing no objection, the motion is carried. Thank you very much, Chairman Mabiman. Would you like to say something? Mamaya na. Okay. So for the final... Sige, Congresswoman Dobrales.
Hello. Nakikinig po lang kasi ako, Mr. Chair, no? And as party list, yung budget naman namin is nationwide. And syempre, isang babae, nararamdaman ko isang paghihirap ng mga babae, especially kung solo merit at syempre, kailangan na ng livelihood. So, galing na lang po sa budget ko, I will commit to So, meron na po kayong Tesla from Geraldine SLB. Dugangan pa na ako ng AKAP.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Congresswoman. It's a grand smile. By the way, a party list, yes. PBA party list, not PBA representative. So, magbibigay po silang tulong. And thank you for Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez kasi ito pong pinibigay namin ng mga social services. Galing po talaga sa kanila. Galing po sa kanya yung allocation. So, thank you very much. Again, thank you. On record, thank you very much, Congresswoman Rex Dobrales. Thank you, Ma'am Congresswoman Geraldine Duman. So, for the last speaker, Kantem Yuran, na Freddy Ran. Rods. Yeah. For the last speaker, I guess si... We listen to tik manabilang family name. Ah, hindi ako nasa. Ano siya mo hindi kakahari? Sige, barangay captain na ako. Raya Madaya 2. Thank you. You have 2 minutes, ma'am.
Assalamualaikum. Good morning. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Amna Manabilang Parambangan, Barangay Chairperson of Raya Madaya 1, Marawi City. Thank you, Mr. Chair, and the rest of the hardworking staff of the community for facilitating this public hearing. Mr. Chair, I'll get straight to the point. My concern is the repair of mosques within the most affected areas. In April 2022, the DHSUT entered into a memorandum of agreement and contract of services for the repair of the Raya Madaya 1 mosque in my barangay. However, despite the completion of the repairs, the building payment has not been released. Mr. Chair, batid naman po natin lahat ang kalagayan ng mga IDPs, lalo na ang mga residente ng most affected areas. Kailangan pa po ba na talaga natin magpakaawa sa gobyerno para tuparin ng isang pinirmahang kontrata? Bukod sa hindi pa nakakauwi ang ating mga residente makalipas ang 7 taon, kailangan pa po namin magpakaawa para sa ipatupad ang isang kontrata kung makakuha man lang ng malinaw na sagot. Paano po magkakaroon ng sinasabi na hinihiling kung patuloy ganitong sistema? The repair of the mosque was not favoring any religion. It was like any other structure damaged by the siege, essential to the life of the community and necessary for the rehabilitation. Please, Mr. Chair, in all congressional hearings that we are watching, we hope to relay and prioritize this concern.
Thank you very much, Ms. Parambangan of Barangay Raya Madaya 1. Actually, yung kanina po sinabi ko, tinanong ko si Yasin kasi I heard the budget is already in this. But let me work on it, ma'am. We can finally answer that, address your concerns. So, thank you very much for your participation, ladies and gentlemen. With indulgence of my colleagues, I will speak again verbatim. Ang bunalaman na nakat sa kanulamon, kagi public hearing na, no, naging kasuccessful na kanusyaso. Dami man ang sulawan ng mga concerns niyo sa mga problema niyo na hindi yung ikataon ito na ikakasumbo. Napatan niya nakakasumbo na pero niyo nga kami sa mga problema, ako makapagpagod ko patanong. Pag yung problema sa Marawi City, wala mong naging rehabilitation na hindi yung sa katao-tao. Ang pagkagasin, nasaktano lang. Bago ko patanong, panalamatan na huwag yung mga kongres mga pinakadyan, Congressman Chino Albario, Congresswoman Mix Ugrales, Congressman Bobby Imano, Congresswoman Geraldine Roman, si Congressman Rods Gutierrez. Saka, yan pa mga kumairan siya. Kasi yan siya pa kumairan. Nakatabi mo kayo sila ng ano sa mga tabang. So, pinalamatan na ako si Ran, pinalamatan na ako si Governor Pongin Londonio, sa kaya ako steran kami siya, pinalamatan na ako ng militar ang PNP. O kaya ulo din ang kami, sa kaya pinalubatan ako sa kaya pamisitan ako sa mga sites na. Kaya mala, pero mura ka doon, nabay siya may food. Siya po yung pag-ipo, siya po yung nabay siya may glass. Siya kayo papapagampunan po nang yung mga public consultation na doon. Kaya diritsyo, instruction, President Bongbong Marcos na mapasa na diyan niya rehabilitation, kambubayanan, Judah Patabayanan, okay, nasusuportan ni Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez Jr. Panalamatan namin sa kanungulawon, sa dito kapakandaraydon, sa kanyang pakapapasay tayo siya. Panalamatan namin na HCNHA, panalamatan namin na Nasureco, niya City Government, Marawi City, panalamatan namin na Giluang, okay, kay General Manager Tano sa Marawi City for being candid and giving us as honest as possible. The information that we want them, we want us to understand. And thank you for your candid and your honesty, for your answers and for your inputs. Again, I'd like to say thank you very much for all my colleagues who are present here today. I know you're supposed to enjoy your vacation, but rather you chose to be with us. Maraming, maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. So any concerns?
Mr. Chair?
Yes.
I would like to remind those who were requested to submit their copy. And move to suspend our meeting, Mr. Chair.
Motion to suspend the hearing during night with seconded the committee hearing on of the Marawi Ad Hoc Committee on Marawi Rehabilitation is hereby suspended. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.